morning, everyone. I welcome you. The next topic called curriculum vitae. Curriculum vitae or resume or biodata or biodata. From this topic, you will get how many marks? 5 marks. You are given only one. You have to write that one only. It is the easiest topic you have. So that is called a curriculum vitae, and it's not resume, it's a resume. It's a resume. We know that biodata. So the origin of the word curriculum vitae from Latin. It is a Latin word. It means a course of one's life. What is the meaning of curriculum vitae? Course of one's life, the details of one's life. That is a curriculum vitae. And the next term, resume. This term was derived from French language. It means to summarize. It means same course of one's life, but it is not in detailed one. It's a summarized one. It's a brief one. And the last one, biodata. It is derived from Breton English. Nothing but English. Okay. It means same one course of one's life. Course of one's life or one's own details. The uses of three terms is same. There is no difference. Is it clear? Curriculum vitae, resume, biodata. Okay. So this is the origin of these three terms. Now the definition. Before going to explain the definition, or how can we prepare, or how after what seeing we can prepare this resume or curriculum vitae or biodata. We often see notifications or advertisements or job notifications in the newspapers or on the internet. After seeing the job notifications and advertisements, we have to apply for the job. If you send only your name and address, these details are not enough for the prospective employer to guess your qualities, to guess your your skills, to know who are you. Is it clear? So it is not helpful. What are the not helpful? The details. What are the details? Name and address is not enough to assess you are fit for the company or not, or how far you can helpful for the company or not. So that we have to send some more details about you. What are the details means details which can helpful for the employer to assess your qualities, to assess your skills, to assess your habits, to assess how far you are helpful for the company. So that you must send curriculum vitae or resume or biodata. So what is the curriculum vitae or what is the resume or what is the biodata? Here a curriculum vitae or resume or biodata is a document. What is that? It is a document. Document means it is a paper which provides an individual's personal, academic and professional details. Is it clear? CV is a document. Resume also document. Biodata also document. A document which provides an individual's what is that? Personal, academic and professional. Personal means name, gender, date of birth, age, father name, all those things. Academic means educational qualifications and technical qualifications. So, and professional means where you have worked previously, your experience. If you get any awards, if you receive any things, you can mention in the professional details. Is it clear? A document which provides an individual's personal, academic and professional details is called CV. CV nothing but curriculum. It is a short form of curriculum vitae. It's a CV or resume. This is a definition of CV or resume. Curriculum vitae or resume or biodata. Okay, this is the definition. And the difference. Let us identify the difference between CV and resume. CV and resume, curriculum vitae and resume. We don't have a topic called biodata in our syllabus. We have only two forms, that is a curriculum vitae and resume. So the main difference between what is a curriculum vitae and resume is in form of length, in terms of length, in terms of subject matter, in terms of use. There are only three differences between these two terms, curriculum vitae and resume. One is the length, the other one is the subject matter, what you include in the document, and next one the use of CV and use of what is that resume. The length of CV is two pages or more than two pages. As CV includes a lot of personal details, so that the length of the CV is two pages or more than two pages. But the length of resume is one page or two pages, not more than two pages, one or two pages only. The length of resume is how many pages? Only one or two pages. Is it clear? Because the resume is a short form of CV. We need not give a more personal details, more academic details and more professional details. We have to convey just a short and a brief details of a person. Who sends a resume to some organization to get a job. Is it clear? So the length of CV is resume is one or two pages. That is the first difference. And the second difference is a subject matter. What kind of things can be mentioned in the CV or resume? The subject matter is, we have to mention the personal details, academic details and professional details, honors and awards and publications and achievements. CV includes personal details, academic details and professional details. Along with these three, we have to mention honors, awards, publications. Is it clear? And achievements in that company. So this is the subject matter in CV. You have to mention all these things in the CV. Come to the resume. The same things are mentioned here in brief, not in detailed one, not in elaborated one, a short one. Need not give much details of personal life, need not give much details of academic and professional. Need not to mention honor and awards and publications or anything. Just a short details of a person and short details of academic and professional and personal details of a person in the resume. The resume conveys these things. Is it clear? And the uses. The uses of CV is to apply for the jobs in educational institutes, like the jobs in schools, the jobs in colleges, the jobs in universities. Universities, they have to use which kind of form? CV, not resume. So, and we can use CV for the jobs in scientific organizations, scientific labs and research organizations. Scientific and research organizations. This is the uses of CV. Is it clear? CV can be used to apply for the jobs in educational institutes, jobs in scientific and research organizations. Scientific and research organization, nothing but laboratories. Is it clear? And the uses of resume is to apply the jobs in business sectors. To apply jobs in a business sectors. Business sectors. So if you want to apply for the post of manager, you must use a resume, not CV. If you want to send a job of medical representative, we must use a resume. Our assistant manager, our assistant engineer, our sales manager, sales executive, we must use which kind of form? Only resume, not CV, not a CV. CV can be used for the jobs in educational institute, means to lecturer, to post of lecturer, to post of teacher, to post of principal, to post of professor, or assistant professor, we must use what is that? CV. Is it clear? Our lab assistant, our lab technician. Okay, we should use CV. We should use the CV. This is the uses of CV and resume. And these are the difference between CV and resume. CV and resume. Curriculum vitae and resume. Now come to the preparation. The importance on the preparation. The steps we must use in preparation of CV or resume. CV or resume. Listen carefully. So our CV or resume should be impressive. Should be impressive. Should be neat and clean. Neat and clean. Why should we prepare our CV or resume in impressive mode, impressive manner, or a neat and clean manner? Because your CV or resume represent you. Your CV or resume represents you. You are not going to the particular organization directly to get a job. Instead of you, what is that? Your CV and your resume, what is that? Reach the organization. After seeing, after know what is that, verifying your CV or your resume, the particular employer or prospective employer assess whether he will send a call letter to you or not. So that is the reason why you must use you must prepare a CV or resume in an impressive manner. It should be impressive. It should be impressive, neat and clean. Neat and clean. Is it clear? So, there is a chance of going directly to the interview or to get, there is a chance of going a person directly to the, what is that, office to get a job. You can maintain a good dress code. Okay? And you maintain a correct body structure, then you will get a job. But there is no that kind of sense. So that you should prepare CV or resume in impressive manner. This is the first point. And the second one is, so you should include important and genuine details in the CV. While you are preparing CV or resume, you should be very careful in giving important details, necessary details, and genuine details. Don't boast yourself in CV. How to give genuine details? Genuine details. If you give fake details, fake things in your CV, you will be caught during the interview. In the interview, the interviewer may ask questions on the based on your CV or your, what is that, resume. Is it clear? So that you should mention important and genuine details in your CV or what is that, resume. Details must be important and genuine. You should not mention fake details. And the one, during the interview, you must produce or submit original certificate also. Original certificates. So that So you should avoid the fake details. You should avoid giving fake details in your CV or resume. This is the second one. And the third point, prepare a new one every time by one's own. So you have to prepare your own CV. Don't ask somebody to prepare your CV or resume. Is it clear? So you should go to the internet, or you should use your laptop to prepare what is your CV or resume. Don't ask others to prepare your CV because your CV is the only one main source to get a call letter to you, to get a job to you. So that you should be very careful in preparing your CV when you are going to apply for a job, and you are going to apply for a job. Is it clear? So it should be prepared by yourself. It should be prepared by yourself, and prepare a new one every time when you are going to apply a job. You should prepare a new CV. You should prepare a new resume. Don't use the same resume or same curriculum vitae to apply to different jobs and to different sectors. Is it clear? Because the demands and expectations and the demands expectations are different for different jobs. Is it clear? For example, you prepared a CV for the post of lecturer in a college, maths lecturer in a college. Don't use the same format to apply for a post in a medical representative in a pharmaceutical company. Is it clear what I'm saying? You prepared a CV for using to apply post of lecturer. Because the demands and requirements and expectations of lecturer is different from the expectations of what is the medical representative. So that you should prepare a new CV whenever you are going to apply for a job. Is it clear what I am saying? You should prepare a new one. In preparation of a new CV, you should, in your mind, you should maintain, you should have a idea about the requirements of the job. The expectations of the, employer who gives a job to you, Is it clear? Prepare a new one. And last point is, don't send a Xerox copy. Don't get Xerox of your CV or a resume when you are going to apply for a job. You should type your own, and you should print it your own, and you have to send your CV or resume directly to a company. Is it clear? So don't use Xerox copy. You should use a neat copy which is printed by you and which is typed by you. This is the preparation. These are the steps we should use in preparation. What is that? CV should be impressive and neat and clean, and you should mention important and genuine details. And one more thing, you have to prepare a new CV every time. And it should be prepared by your own. And don't send a Xerox copy. You should use a new copy every time, which is printed by you, which is typed by you. So this is the thing. I'm repeating once again: curriculum vitae and resume and bio data. So these are very useful in everyday life after completion of your education. Everyone must send a resume or curriculum vitae to any one of the organizations to get a job. it is not, I am not teaching you this thing in the point, in exam point of view. It is very helpful after completion of your education also. So this is the important definition and difference and the steps in preparation. We will meet again in the next session. Thank you very much. Thank you.